He ain't just putting on the Ritz.
Our God is an awesome God.
There's thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fists.
Our God is an awesome God.
And the Lord wasn't joking when he kicked him out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. His return is very close, and so you better be believing that our God is an awesome God.
Our God is an awesome God.
The night.
Our God is an awesome God.
He spoke into the darkness and created the light.
Our God is an awesome God.
In judgment and wrath he poured out on Sodom, and mercy and grace he gave us at the cross. I hope that we have not too quickly forgotten that our God is an awesome God.
Our God.
Clothing distributor in Los Angeles, and a coat factory in the Philippines. He was one of the most respected Christian businessmen in his city. He had good relations with all his sons and daughters, and they would all take turns visiting each other's homes at different times of the year, so that it seemed his grandchildren were always around. Every morning he prayed for his children, thinking, God, please make them all be true followers of you. Perhaps they are just putting on a Christian image for my sake, and in their hearts they are hypocrites. One day the angels came to present themselves before the Lord in heaven.
Where have you come from?
From roaming through the earth and going back and forth in it.
Have you noticed my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is righteous and good, a man who fears God and shuns evil.
Does he get nothing out of following you? Haven't you put a hedge around him and his household and everything he has? You have blessed the work of his hands so that he makes money hand over fist. But if you stretched out your hand and struck down everything he has, he would surely curse you to your face.
Are you so sure? Very well. Everything he has is in your hands, but you may not lay a finger on the man himself.
Come in.
Mr. Job! Mm-hmm. I took the flight through the night and just got here an hour ago. Your place in Los Angeles was raided by a gang last night. They raided the place with machine guns, and after they took what they wanted, they burned it down. There's nothing left. I was the only one who got out alive. I didn't want to talk to you on the phone. I needed to come speak to you in person. I'm sorry, sir. Mr. Joe, I apologize for interrupting, but I have terrible news. There's been a huge explosion at the tannery outside of town. They think a gas main had a leak. A fireball ripped through the whole place, killing everyone on the site. I was the only one to get out in time. I rushed right over. It just happened. Mr. Job, I know this is a real blow, but I don't know what to do next. Mr. Job, I'm sorry for interrupting, but I've got to speak with you right away. I just got in from the airport. Your factory in the Philippines. It was attacked by Muslim revolutionaries last night. I wanted to speak with you in person before it gets on the news. It's been burned to the ground. 300 employees were killed. I was the only one to make it out in time. I took the flight through the night and just got here an hour ago.
I can't believe this.
That's two disasters in one night.
No, three.
What are you talking about? What's going on?
Mr. Joe. I just came from your oldest son's house. I can't. I have to. The children, they were all together with the grandchildren, celebrating a birthday party at your son's house. And a tornado! The whole house is destroyed! I was just leaving in my car, so I'm the only one to get out in time. Mr. Joe, your children are all dead. I'm so sorry.
Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked I will depart. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The destruction of the factories forced Job into bankruptcy. He lost everything. The family had a funeral for all 10 children and grandchildren, the saddest funeral the city had ever had. But in all this, Job did not curse God or lose his faith.
King of kings.
Where have you come from?
From roaming through the earth and going back and forth in it.
Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil. And he still maintains his integrity, even though you incited me against him to ruin him for no reason.
Skin for skin. As long as a man has his health, he can be happy. But if you stretched out your hand and struck down his flesh and bones, he would surely curse you to your face.
Very well then. He is in your hands, but you must spare his life.
So Satan afflicted Job with painful sores from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. The doctors had never seen such a disease, and could not cure it. The itching was so bad that Job scratched constantly at the sores.
Don't tell me you're still praying.
Yes, I'm still praying, dear.
I don't know how you can still believe in God. Why don't you just curse into his face and die?
That is foolish. Shall we accept good from God and not bad?
Trite religious phrases. Still the trite religious phrases. I spent the best years of my life raising our children, and all you can say is, the Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Don't you have anything to say? I used to think you knew what you were talking about. But now I don't want to hear about your loving God. I can't take it anymore. I have to get away.
One day, Job's three closest friends came to visit him. They knew him and loved him and were shaken to the core by the things that had happened to him. They had agreed to spend a week together with Job in a prayer vigil. For 7 days in a row, they stayed with Job. No one said a thing. His three friends just stayed with Job and grieved with him and prayed.
Something I've always known.
the seventh day, Job finally spoke.
Cursed be the day I was born! Cursed be the night they said a boy is born. May it turn to darkness. May it not be included among the days of the year. Cursed be that day because I did not die at birth. Cursed be the fact that there was food to feed me. Why did I not die as a child? The weary find rest in death. The slave is freed from his master. The poor man is freed from his debt, but not I! Why is light given to those in misery, and life to those with bitter souls? Why doesn't death come to those who long for it, who search for it more than for hidden treasure, who would be filled with gladness and rejoice when they reach the grave? Why does life linger on for a man whom God has fenced in from every direction? I can't eat. I can only groan. My worst fears have come upon me. I have no rest, no quietness. I have no peace, but only anxiety. Therefore I say, cursed be the day I was born.
Joe. Really hesitate to speak. You have always been the one to counsel us. I've always looked up to you. You've always helped others in trouble. But now you are in trouble and you're stumbling. Joby, you've been a good Christian man. I know God would not turn his back on you. Now, I know some people bring trouble upon themselves. They secretly do evil and think they can get away with it, but eventually their deeds find them out. I've seen it myself, men who paraded as virtuous Christians who were really hypocrites. And the truth finally came out. Now, of course you're not sinless, Job. If God charges his angels with error, then how much more those who live in houses of clay? But I know you're a man of integrity. Therefore, you should have faith that God will hear your prayers and answer you. Think about how great God's power is. He's a miracle-working God. He can do anything. He sends the rain that waters the fields, and he directs the rivers in the countryside. He's done more miracles than you or I can count. I believe he can do a miracle for you, Job. Remember, the Bible says, the prayer of a righteous man availeth much. If you're right with God, then have hope. God answers prayer. You can be healed, and you can even have another family. Surely man is born to trouble as sparks fly upward. Sometimes God sends trouble into our lives to discipline us, to chasten us, even though he loves us. But if he wounds, he also heals. So I say again, pray and expect a miracle. I know God will hear you and bless you. I'm sure all three of us agree.
What strength do I have that I should have hope? The arrows of God are sunk deep in my back. God's terrors are marshaled against me. There is only one thing that I hope for. That God would put me out of my misery. Then I could die, knowing that I had not turned my back on God. Your words are of no help. Will you correct what I have said? A man in despair should have the sympathy of his friends, even if he has forsaken God. Instead, you are afraid to look at the truth. It is too dreadful for you. You are even afraid to look at my face. Have I ever asked anything from you before? For favors? For money? Then listen to me now. You say I should have hope. Let me tell you the hard truth. Look at life. Is not every man's lot on earth a hard service? We forget about it at times, but everyone's life is like a shadow, like a breath that vanishes. My suffering is the rule, not the exception. So I will make my complaints to God. I will not be silent. I will speak in my anguish. Am I a monster that you must put me under guard? What have I done to you? I can't even sleep because of the terrible dreams that I have. You frighten me so much with your terrors that I prefer to be strangled and die rather than to live this life. What is man that you make so much of him, to give him so much attention? Why do you care about every little detail of our lives? If I have done something wrong, why can't you forgive me? Ugh. Why can't you let us live our lives without always testing us? Oh, and punishing us? Oh, oh, ah, oh, oh, ah.
God of injustice. Can anyone say they've gotten anything they didn't deserve? The Bible says the wages of sin is death. We're all sinners. We all must die. Your children were sinners, and they died because death is the penalty for sin. But have hope. I agree with Eliphaz. You should pray and trust God that He can do miracles. If you are indeed not hiding any sin, then you can be confident that God will listen to your prayers. Now, if you have a guilty conscience, then you need to get right with God. But if you are at peace with God, then you should trust that the God who loves you gives good things to His children. If you have a clear conscience, then you can have hope that you will know even laughter again.
Of course I know we are all sinners. God can justly punish us for any one of the many sins we do in life. But would it make any difference if He were unjust? Who could tell Him He had judged wrongly? He made the sun and the stars and the mountains and the seas. If I were to argue with Him, He could make my own mouth speak words to condemn myself. I don't believe He would even listen. Is there an arbitrator to stand between me and God? Someone to remove God's rod of terror from me? so that I can make my case? Suppose I decided just to put on a happy face and forget about it. I know that in your hearts, you would still think I am a worse sinner than you. That all these things have happened to me because God is cursing me for some great sin. So I don't care what you think. Nothing worse can happen to me. So I'll say what I want. This is what I say to God. What good is it to punish me for some sin if you don't even tell me what you're punishing me for? Tell me what charges you have against me. Should I live my life every moment wondering if I have done something that you will punish me for? Do you scrutinize our lives and examine every little thing in order to strike us down for some sin we don't even remember? If you are so displeased with us, why did you create us in the first place? Do you despise the work of your own hands? You knit me together with bones and sinew, and you sustained me by your spirit, and now you hunt me down like a lion. Why? If a person is wicked, then woe unto him. But even if I try hard to please you, you still attack me. All I ask is that you leave me alone. Just let me have a little comfort and let me die.
This is ridiculous. I don't want to hurt your feelings, but how can you say these things? You're saying that God is unjust, as though you never sin, and he is punishing you for nothing. Well, know this, God has even forgotten some of your sin. I didn't want to bring this up, but since you mentioned it, it does seem pretty coincidental that all these things are happening to you at once. If ever there were a case for the hand of God being at work, this is it. I don't know anything that you might have done, but God is omniscient. No one can hide anything from him. We're not trying to judge you, Job. We're trying to give you hope. If you repent of your sin and confess it to God, he is full of mercy. God promises to answer our prayers if we have faith. But if you keep sin in your life, it blocks your prayers. If you turn back to him, he'll forgive you and you won't have to fear anything. God wants to bless you and give you hope. Just turn back to him.
No doubt you are the people, and wisdom will die with you. They used to say that I was wise. Who doesn't know that God is behind this? Ask the animals or the birds of the air, and they will tell you. The life of every living being is in the hands of God. I know my theology as well as you. God is omniscient and omnipotent. He ordains everything that comes to pass. He sets up kings and throws them down. What he breaks, no one can rebuild. All I want is to be able to talk to God. I just wish that I could reason with him. Will you defend God with false accusations and empty platitudes? Now hold your peace. And let me make my case. I place myself in God's hands. even though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. If I were a hypocrite, then I wouldn't be able to stand before him. But I'm not, so I'll defend myself. After that, let come what may. But I have to speak, or I won't be able to stand it. God, I want to talk to you. I want to hear from you. I just ask that you don't terrify me with your power. Let me stand before you. You can speak first, and I will answer you. Or, if you like, I'll go first and you answer. Are you ready? All I want is for you to tell me what sin I've done to deserve all this. Why do you hide your face? Why don't you speak more clearly? What have I done to you? Will you frighten a wind-blown leaf? Have you brought back on me the sins of my youth? When a man dies, where is he? When a tree dies, it is reborn as a tender shoot from the trunk. But a man is gone, like a dried up river. But when a man dies and is laid away, where is he? Is there really life after death? God, I just hope that you will overlook me when I die until your anger is past. I will wait for you to renew me. You will call me and I will answer you. You will forgive my sin and seal it up in a bag. But you destroy the hope of man. You wear him down like a torrent of water wearing away a stone. Our hope is worn down until we give up and die.
Job, you're casting off all fear of God. You're questioning everything now and talking like any worldly unbeliever. Were you the first man who was born? What do you know that we don't? I've been trying to give you consolation from God, but a gentle word has made no impact with you. Let me tell you something. I've been around for a while, and I've seen the way God works in this world. Sometimes a man keeps up a good image for a long time, gets rich and fat, but he's really an oppressor who hates God and defies him. Then suddenly, his house collapses around him and he's found out. He trusted in his wealth, but he was deceived. He's suddenly filled with terrors and shame. I've seen religious leaders with television programs lose their entire empires. Hypocrites are always found out!
Oh yes, you guys are great comforters. Words of wind. You miserable comforters! I've heard all this before. What ails you that you keep on talking? If I were in your place and you were in mine, I could shake my head and waggle my words against you too. But I think I would try to really comfort you. Now even my friends turn against me. God, you have worn me out! He tears at me with his teeth and his wrath and hates me. He gnashes at me. They gape at me and reproach me. They consult together against me. God has even taken away my friends and turned me over to having enemies. He pierces my heart now and breaks open my wounds in his wrath. He takes me by the neck and shakes me. And now I can't stop crying. I can't stand it. I tried, God. You know my prayers were real. You know I am not a hypocrite who has filled his hands with violence. Oh, earth, do not let my cry have no resting place. Surely there is a witness in heaven. Oh, that there is someone in heaven who will plead for a man as a man pleads for his neighbor in a court case. God, you have hidden their hearts from understanding. They spit in my face now and mock me. They are astonished at me. They call me a hypocrite. But you know I'm not. Will you pledge friendship with me yourself? Ah! None of them will shake my hand. Ah! I can see the darkness coming. God has even scattered my thoughts. Oh, I can't keep my thoughts straight. I say to the worm, you are my mother, and to rot, you are my father. Oh. Shall we rest together in the dust? Who can see my hope? Is my hope dead?
Staring up at the stars in the sky.